Growing up in Orlando, Florida, Nik was a bright, vibrant kid, engaged in school and active with his friends and family. But in 2010, his parents started noticing small changes in Nik that would turn out to be signs of a big problem.
He fell asleep in the middle of a play date.
It was probably 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning, and he said, "It feels like my back's broken."
His elbow was swollen, his knee was swollen.
It like escalated from, "Hey, you might have a little bit of soreness," to, "Hey, something big's going on." We went to get blood work, and on the way home, they called and said, "You need to rush him to the hospital." I was walking with the nurse while they're wheeling the carts through the halls, and there's a big giant sign that says, "Children's Oncology." "Why are we going into the oncology ward?" Dr. Selsky sat down, and he had said, "You know, Nicholas has leukemia." I remember it was like getting punched in the face.
I was so confused. I thought I was just going to be fine. I just knew they sold pink cookies at school for cancer. Never in the back of my mind did I think that I would get cancer.
After diagnosis, Nik and his family went to Florida Hospital to start the standard round of chemotherapy treatments.
Usually it's like the first 30 days you do really heavy chemotherapy. Then you test afterwards, and then in most cases, that's it. But when they tested him after the initial treatment, he still had cancer. He did a lot of chemo, and there was times we'd be at the clinic 3 days a week. He wasn't able to eat. He was throwing up nonstop.
You just always feel sick. You never really felt good when you're going through chemo.
He would be in a lot of pain, headache, just pure anger. And that was one of the first times I think we realized the power of his love for Star Wars. While we screamed, we would ask him Star Wars questions, and then it would kind of calm him down.
We put it as, okay, cancer's the dark side. To him, he was a Jedi. It took him away from it all, and then it also helped to give him strength to fight it.
We did 2 years of treatment. 2 years he didn't go to school.
The school were very, very supportive. They made orange bands as the Forces with you, Nik.
The whole school, the church, everybody helped out. They just rallied.
We were 6 months out, like he was almost done, and that's when he relapsed.
Acute lymphoblastic leukemia is curable in 90% of patients, but for the remaining 10%, relapse is a terrifying reality.
It was like you get one more dose of hardcore chemo, and if this doesn't work, and, you know, there's nothing we can do for you except for to make you comfortable until you go.
Dr. Selsky came in and said, "There's a study that you can go into. The problem is that you got to be there tomorrow."
With few options left to them, Nik was placed on a clinical trial assembled and funded by the Stand Up to Cancer St. Baldrick's Pediatric Cancer Dream Team. The collaboration funds cutting-edge research in the field of immunotherapy.
Immunotherapy is the treatment of cancer by teaching the body to fight off the cancer. We can remove immune cells, manipulate them in the laboratory, put them back into the body, and teach them how to effectively remove cancer from the body.
The CD19 treatment was much easier on Nik than the previous therapy, producing fewer side effects and allowing him to get back to his old self.
During the CD19, I always felt relatively normal. That's a lot better than chemo, where you're feeling bad for 3 weeks.
He was up and about more, he ate more, he looked better. It was just a very different experience.
About a week after they did the infusion, I started to feel good. I thought something had gone right.
Absolutely, 100%, it saved his life. That's what CD19 did.
These days, Nik is back to his old life, back to school, friends, and all of his hobbies.
He's active, he wants to play lacrosse, he rides his bike with his brothers.
The whole time he was sick, he never really drew. When he started feeling better, he started to draw again. It was amazing.
He loves to cook, he loves to eat.
Nik is a poster child for the promise of research and the power of dedicated effort. None of this would have happened without Stand Up to Cancer St. Baldrick's funding. The knowledge we have now is exponential compared to what we used to know just a decade ago. These long-standing remissions due to immunotherapy is really, really impressive.
Now he's too cool, you know. He's built at 13 years old. He's got, you know, He's got a beautiful head of hair, which he spends hours on in the morning.
Thanks to Stand Up To Cancer funding innovative research, Nick can now pursue his dreams.
Maybe the best way to thank everybody for what they've done and to thank Stand Up To Cancer for funding this is to live it to the fullest.
I want to live on Anna Maria Island, and I want to own a restaurant and a house right on the beach. And every morning I want to wake up, go on my boat from my house, catch all the fish, and then bring them to my restaurant, and then cook all the fish in my restaurant. And that's how I want to live my life.
Thank you from the bottom of my heart, from everybody who knows Nicholas, from everybody who's going to meet him for the rest of his life. Thank you.